Hello everyone. My name is Sung Lee. Paper title: Different Imitation Learning Performance Analysis According to Emergent-Based Behavior Patterns. Contents: First, introduction. To second, background. Third, experiment method. Fourth, experiment results. Five, conclusion. First, introduction. Reinforcement learning has become a very important part of the game. It balances the game appropriately, generates interest from players, and allows users to focus on gameplay for a long time. In addition, AlphaStar developed by Google DeepMind showed a different aspect of game artificial intelligence than before, actually rising to a high rank, winning stars to pro gamers, and attracting many game players' attention. How it takes a long time to process with reinforcement learning because it requires a huge amount of samples and requires a lot of learning. However, imitation learning can complement such problems and proceed with learning. Imitation learning is imitation with which an agent learns by imitating behavior from humans. In other words, education is provided according to human behavior patterns, and good learning outcomes can be obtained with a small amount of samples depending on human behavior patterns. In this study, if it is possible to know how different learning outcomes are shown to agents, how different the outcomes are, and what similarity and difference show the differences in outcomes, an experiment was conducted to maximize the advantage of imitation learning, and performance analysis results were found. Chapter 2 introduce the background knowledge and technologies necessary for this study. Chapter 3 will introduce how the research method works, the environment set up for the experiment, and other human behavior pattern conditions that lead to prior learning, which is the core of this paper. Chapter 4 contains the experimental result. It will show and compare the result values of agents who have trained different behavior patterns. Compare them with the result values of the best behavior patterns due to certain behavior restrictions and analyze their performance. Second, background and reinforcement learning. Figure 3 is a picture that expresses the reinforcement learning mechanism. Reinforcement learning is a type of machine learning that runs through trial and error. And it is a learning process in which agents and environment interact through information such as action, state, and reward to to exceed a given goal. Reinforcement learning applies to the problem of making decisions sequentially and uses the Markov disease process. To solve sequential decision-making problems, mathematical model. Markov disease process is a very common mathematical modeling method that can express a wide range of real-world problems, including robotics, stocks, and natural language processing, as well as various types of game. Emergence. Each emergence released a better version at Unity as of May 2, 2019, and is now released until release 18, June 9, 2021. It is an open source project that supports games and simulation to serve as an environment for intelligent agent education. Agents can be trained using reinforcement learning, imitation learning, neural bulletin, or other machine learning method through the ease to use Python API. It provides a PyTorch-based algorithm implementation so that game developers and hobbyists can easily train intelligent agents for 2D and 3D and VR AR games. Game engine Unity can be used as a simulator, providing various configurations, values, and training scenario. One agent connected to one brain and a multi-agent connected to one or more brains to interact. In this paper, we will process using the PPO algorithm in a multi-agent environment. PPO algorithm. The PPO algorithm is one of the police gradient techniques introduced by the OpenAI team in 2017. It is John Schmidt's new police optimization algorithm that exercised. And the algorithm is practically modified to be computer friendly by simplifying the complex calculation of TIPO. It is an algorithm performance using two networks, actor and critical. TIPO requires a large amount of computation to solve the construction optimization problem. And PPO has the advantage of reducing computation by possibly setting the confidence interval by the clipping technique when updating the surrogate function. Using the PPO algorithm as emergence, it is used as an algorithm and that can recognize obstacles, find directions, and obtain reward as in the paper. Third, experiment method. Unity ML agent provides multi-agent environment. If you process with learning with multi-agent environment, you can reduce the time spent on learning and increase the outcome value compared to the single agent environment. However, in the multi-agent environment, it is recommended to set the number of agents to an unknown value. Excessive amount of agents can rather degrade performance and obtain poor results. Thus, in this environment, one agent was created and then constructed in 32 multi-agent environment as shown in figure 2 in the form of prepep. In order to implement imitation learning in Unity Emergent, you need to set it up as shown in figure 3. In single agent environment and then create a demo version yourself. This is because we have to show the agent the behavior patterns. The reasons for showing behavior patterns directly is that imitation learning sees dependencies. That is, the efficiency of finding optimal policies. And in the case of DQN, training takes a very long time and requires as many samples as possible to achieve good results. However, in the case of actual reinforcement learning, it is not easy to obtain a large amount of samples. Therefore, in order to learn with imitation learning, a learning method that can reduce the number of samples, humans directly give prior learning to agents and demonstrate with severe server conditions, and they are taught with record plot data. In this paper, performance analysis will be conducted through data record in three different behavior patterns. The learning method will be different based on difference in movement, and the experiment will be conducted with four conditions for each learning method. First, to explain the object before processing with the learning. The blue square object is an agent. The agent presses the orange square object, which is a button that creates an object cap of obtaining compensation. Press the button and the orange circle object is created at a random position, which is an object that can acquire compensation by hitting the object. After, the object is created at a random location only when a button is pressed again. The PPO algorithm basically provided by emergent was used, and the reward was obtained through game. In addition, it was conducted in 3 million steps of the experiment. There are a total of 3 record flow data as shown in figure 4, and it was conducted in a different flow method. Figure 4 post the condition of figure 1 is not to hit the wall. Second, press the button right away. Third, the orange circle object will be compensated for the shortest distance. Fourth, repeat this behavior 20 times. There are a total of 4 conditions. Figure 4. The condition is figure 2 are to recognize the wall by hitting the wall once. After the start of the record, before pressing the first button, from the second button, press in immediately after creation. Third, the orange circle object will be compensated for the shortest distance. Fourth, repeat these actions 20 times. Therefore, the conditions in figure 3 are to recognize the wall by hitting the wall once in a while before pressing the first button after the start of the record. From the second button, press it immediately after creation. Third, compensation will be obtained by linear movement of the orange circle object on the X and Y axis first. Repeat this action 20 times. First, experiment result. In this study experiment, there are 3 record data with different learning methods, and performance analysis is performed to determine which person's behavior patterns can acquire better outcomes than this time required for agents. Figure 5 to figure 7 show each cumulative reward. And the figure 8 is a graph that can be compared by interleaving each cumulative reward. First, the experimental result of figure 5 is the result of figure 4. 1. It was conducted in a total of 3 million steps, and I wanted to obtain a reward from 300 steps, but I could the reward value again from 760,000 and continue to acquire the mean reward value from 1,060,000 steps. The agent also showed good performance by continuously showing the behavior of buttons and result object. Second, the experimental result of figure 6 are the result of figure 4, number 2, the difference from the experiment in figure 5 was that the reward was acquired after recognizing the wall. It was conducted in 3 million steps, and I wanted to show the result at 120,000, but From 1,040,000 steps, agent gradually acquired compensation. From 1,340,000 steps, agent can continue to acquire mineral values by showing that they acquire or rewards by recognizing the world. It was found that the customers destroyed it, unlike the figure 5 experiment. Finally, that experimental result of figure 7 are the result of figure 4 number 3. Unlike figure 5, the above experiment also recognized the world first, and there is a difference that it has the most strict behavior pattern of movements compared to the two other experiments. As in the two experiments above, it was conducted in 3 million steps, and it took a little longer for the agent to complete the learning. From 1,706,000 steps, the agent acquired the compensation little by little. And from 2,300,000, all agents acquired the compensation, allowing them to continue to acquire the mean reward values. Performance was the most degraded by recognizing restrictions and war on movement. Figure 8 was able to compare the list of the above three experiments by interacting them even visually. It was possible to compare and analyze the performance in the other steps from figure 5 to figure 7. Among the conditions, the behavior pattern that allows buttons and levers to be acquired at the shortest distance without recognizing the world was applied faster than other behavior patterns, and many rewards were acquired within a short period of time, resulting in good result. Conversely, if the world was first recognized under conditions and the movement was limited to a straight line in the X and Y axis, the agent also began to acquire rewards in a slower time than other outcomes, and learning was applied to all agents. Table 1 received the reward values of figure 8 and write the step value until missing mean reward. Even from the exact numerical values, it can be seen that the first reward step and mean reward numbers differ significantly, and the learning rate varies depending on the behavior pattern. Table 2 is a table that summarizes the cumulative rewards according to the steps in figure 8. After the rewards reaches 1, the figure does not change significantly and until the end of the experiment. The agent is showing a well-trained and stable mean reward. Imitation learning has the advantage of being able to proceed with reinforcement learning without a large number of samples by showing human behavior patterns as prior learning. However, since humans educate prior learning, the reward value varies depending on how they educate them. In this paper, the time for the agent to be learned according to different behavior patterns, as in the experiment, was not the same. And the more limited movement there were, the different result of acquiring mean reward were significantly different from the data previously learned. It was concluded that even with similar conditions, performance varies depending on how prior learning is educated. In future studies, performance analysis will be conducted through new added behavior patterns on the field where exact and ambitious that requires damage by attacking sensor to agent. Thank you, everyone.